Okay. So I need to inform you that we have a slight change in our list, that today we are going to visit Cambodia, and
Cambodia.
tomorrow, yes, and tomorrow we are going to see Canada. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Okay,
Okay.
ma'am.
So for today, your pilot is Spandana. Co-pilot is Mandir and crew member is Injani. That is me. Over to you, Spandana.
Hello everyone. So today we are visiting Cambodia. Have you heard of this country before?
Yes, ma'am. I've heard. Yes, ma'am. It's in Asia only.
Yes, yes, it is actually. Okay, let's discuss about it. Okay. So. Wait a minute. Okay. So you can see the map, right? The red colored mark is where Cambodia is. It's pretty near to India, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, it's near Thailand or something.
Yes, it is. It actually shares borders with Thailand. Let me show you the zoomed in version. So you can see the arrow mark over here near Thailand and Vietnam. Cambodia is present. Okay, so about the country, Cambodia is also called as Kampuchea. So the continent, as you said, it's in Asia, and the official name is Kingdom of Cambodia. And it shares borders with Thailand, Laos, Vietnam, and Gulf of Thailand also. So the capital is called as Phnom Penh. So it's pronounced as Phnom Penh. And the largest city is also Phnom Penh. And it has a population of about 15 million. So let's see the national flag.
So the entire country, ma'am, the entire country has the population of only 15 million.
Yes, yes. Entire country has a population of 15 million. How much do you remember how much does India has? India's population?
I think it's 133 crore.
Yeah, 1.3 billion. This is in million actually. So this is the national flag of Cambodia. It's three horizontal bands with blue and red and blue color. So this color represents the bravery of the nation, liberty, that is freedom, and cooperation and brotherhood. And the symbol which you see is called as Angkor Wat. It's a famous temple of Cambodia. It's like their base for Buddhism. That's where, because of that, the Buddhism has spread all over Cambodia. So it means a lot to them. That's why it is a symbol of their national flag. And it also symbolizes the justice, heritage, and integrity. The flag is a representation of nation's religion, the king, and the people. So we'll speak about the national capital city. You remember that it's also the largest city, right?
Yes,
so
ma'am.
It is also the most populous city of Cambodia. It has about population of 2.1 million. If the whole country is 15 million, this city has 2.1 million. Okay, yeah. So it is the nation's economic, industrial, and cultural center, because all the main industries and all the cultural like music, dance forms, everything is there in this city. And it is also, Phnom Penh was formerly known as Krong Chaktomuk Serai Mongkol, which means the city of Brahma's faces. Lord Brahma, you know, right? The four faces of Lord Brahma. That's what the city was named after. Okay, this city is surrounded by rivers which provide fresh water to the city, and it is also called as economic center, as it provides largely for the Cambodia's economy. There are many industries and services so that people can go and work a lot, and that's how they provide economy to the country. So they have many museum schools and music events also. That's why it is called as the cultural center. So see the city. This is how the Phnom Penh looks like. It's a very famous city also of Cambodia. See the architecture. It's all very ancient architectures. Mostly
it
inspired
like
by Buddhism. Yes, I think almost all India and the neighboring countries, they all have the same inspirations. Buddhism, Ramayana, Mahabharata, and all those things. That's why. So the language, there are many languages in Cambodia. Indigenous language, that is the native language itself, is like 19 language. But the national language is called as Khmer. The scripts which you can see over here is called as Khmer language. And it is widely spoken, like 90% of the population speak this language. And other languages spoken are Chinese and Vietnamese. So the religion, as I said, they have a very, very deep-rooted Buddhism in that, and 98% of the people follow Theravada Buddhism. That is a type of Buddhism which they believe in, and other 1% believe in Christianity, and the remaining are Islam and atheism. Do you know what atheism is?
No, ma'am.
Atheism means they do not
atheism means that you do not follow or believe in God.
They do not believe in the existence of God itself. So they do not follow any of the religion. That's what is called as atheism.
Yes, okay. They are atheists.
Yeah. So this is a national animal. It's called as Kupre. And it is also known as Cambodian ox, gray ox, Indo-Chinese ox, and also Toro Kupre in Spanish. So it is a herbivore animal, which means it eats grass for as a diet. And it is hard to find and is believed to be mostly extinct. Do you know why it's called as mostly extinct?
Because it's extremely endangered, only a few number of
the animals. It's like they don't know whether it's totally extinct or not. It's already a rare and shy animal, so you can't see it normally. And they saw it few years ago, and after that it like completely disappeared. Nobody saw it for few more years, and it suddenly appeared. So they do believe in the country. So this is a national bird. It's a giant ibis. This is also a very shy in nature. And very few giant ibis is found now. Deforestation, that is cutting down of trees, and also climate change are the reason for the decline of birds' number.
That's bad.
Yeah, really, right? We have to protect the environment that and climate also. Otherwise, all these birds and animals, it will not be anywhere seen.
Yeah.
And they are also the national animal and bird of that country. So they have to take more care of that. So speaking about national flower, so Rumdual is a national flower, which you can see over here, the yellow color. It is found everywhere in Cambodia. It is pretty popular in traditional medicine. They follow traditional medicine over there also. So like how we follow Ayurveda here. And they use this flower for many medicinal purposes. And it is very fragrant and pretty to look at. Because of its fragrance, this flower is used to make lip wax, like a makeup product, which is used by women in Cambodia. And the next one. So are you liking Cambodia so far?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am. So do you remember what is the capital of Cambodia?
Phnom Penh.
All right. So we are speaking about Cambodian cuisine now. So the rice and fish are like staple food. That is a basic food. They usually eat it in every meal.
Kerala as a country.
Yes. Okay. There are many varieties of food, and a typical meal is usually served with steamed rice, a soup variety, and a number of side dishes. So let me show you a few of them. Fish amok, or it is also steamed fish in a banana leaves. And the next one is a loklak, a stir-fried beef in a brown sauce. These are like the foods of Cambodia. Okay, so the next few food I'm showing you is mee kola. These are the noodles dishes, kola noodles, and Q2, it's a noodle soup. So we are going to speak about the culture of Cambodia. So it's a very ancient country. So the very deep-rooted cultures are there. This is a very classical dance form, and it is very stylized, as you can see. It's very fashionable, and they put on the very best costumes they have. And they usually depict their culture and about Ramayana or their own gods. So that's how they show in this dance. And the next one is folk dance. This is not as stylized or as big of a costumes as you have seen in the classical dance. This usually is like showing the stories of the farmers or the local people, how they are. And they also have peacock dance like this. So this is the dance forms. So the wildlife in Cambodia. So I think this is Abir's favorite one. Okay, what is this? Do you know this bird?
Flamingo.
Okay. Correct. So do you know any facts about flamingo?
Flamingos aren't actually pink in color. They become pink, I think, because of the various bacteria that are present in the water.
Yes. They are actually gray in color when they are babies, and they grow up to be pinkish in color. And even their what they eat also depends on what kind of pink they will be.
They stand and sleep on one leg.
Sorry, I didn't understand you, Sudarshan.
They sleep on one leg.
Okay. So do you know which animal is this?
This is a dole.
Yes, it is. So can you say something about dole?
You know that doles are also found in India.
Okay. So they are like wild dogs. And they are very, very fast.
For foxes.
Yeah, they are very, very fast runners. And they can also swim and they can jump very high. Okay. So the next one, what is this?
A slow leopard.
What the name? It's one of those jumpers.
Ocelot? Caracal? Lynx?
It's an ocelot. I believe
it's a leopard cat. It's a leopard cat. It's a carnivorous animal, which is a meat-eating animal. And it is a nocturnal animal, which means it is up during the night. So it's very rare to see this animal. It's also a little bit shy in nature. This one.
Sea turtle.
Yes, sea turtle. Which variety is this? It lives for hundreds of years.
This is my favorite out of all of these. Ooh.
Snakes. What is this snake?
Green mamba.
Okay, it is actually a green bit viper. It is also.
I love those.
You like snakes and the crocodiles and all those things, right?
Yes.
Yes.
But so this is you like them as long as you don't meet them.
Yeah. So this is actually also called as bamboo viper because they are usually found near the bamboo plants, and Thailand recorded the highest poison from this viper some year or so. Because if they find you attacking them or if they find you threatening, they will bite you. Okay, so be careful.
Only okay. Like all these animals until you meet them face to face.
Yes.
Then you don't like them.
So you should be good to the animals also because they also they're also living beings, right? So you have to be careful around them. If you are good to them, they are also good to you. Unless they are hungry, so that is there. So the tourist places to visit. Okay, so this is called as Korong Samleon. It's a island. It's a very, very famous tourist place. They have many resorts over here and adventures which you can play. So you can go there and relax like this also. Chill and relax, okay? So the next one, this is called as Bandesh Mar. It's a very interesting one. It's called as a mysterious temple, because there are so many architecture over here on the stones. Imagine without the modern technology in that ancient time, building all this architecture without the modern technology. So it's still a mystery to them. So that's why it's called as mysterious temple. See all these structures over there? Okay, so we are seeing the Cambodian airline now. It's a Cambodia Angkor Air. It's a national airline. But they don't go right now to many other countries. Only few countries nearby they go. But this is the Cambodian national airline.
Which all countries do they go?
Like nearby countries, like Thailand, Vietnam and all those things. Yeah. But I think after COVID, they can take over few restrictions. They might go other countries also. So right now, they're only going to nearby places. So with that, we are coming to an end. So did you like Cambodia, visiting Cambodia?
Already?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am, I like
it. Even I didn't think that we would be going this fast today. So which was your favorite animal out of all those things?
Flamingo and green viper.
Yeah, green viper. It was good to look at, right? So yeah. Have you heard of...
I also like typhoon with the nice one.
Sorry?
I also like the same animal.
Yeah.
Mine like the leopard cat and the dog.
And yeah. Flamingos and oaklet.
Yeah. Have you heard of that kupre before, the national animal which I showed you?
No, never.
Never, right? Because I
it's
think
a buffalo shape.
Yeah, it's a narrow-bodied animal. It's like it's bigger than an ox, but a little smaller than a water buffalo. That's how it is. But I think it's because it's a very rare animal. We don't know about that much. Yes, Rohita.
Mom, we don't have McDonald's in Cambodia.
I'm not sure of that.
No,
really? Did you search that?
We don't have McDonald's in Cambodia.
Oh, in some countries actually they have banned all this. Do you know that? All this big corporation like McDonald's and all. Either it's because they have some conflict with their mother, with that country's this one, or because they think it's not good for the health of the people. Maybe because.
Or they have some conflicts with the country.
Yeah, that's what. If they have conflicts with that country, they will ban that items. Like India has banned TikTok and all, right? So same way they have banned McDonald's, I think. Okay. So what was the new thing you learned about Cambodia?
Flag.
Sorry?
Mom?
The flag.
Okay. Rohita, yes?
Mom, Cambodia is one of the poorest countries in the world.
Yeah.
Everything is new for me.
Yeah, Cambodia is actually a, even though it's a very near to India, it's a, you don't hear it often, like Thailand, you have heard of it, Vietnam, you have heard of it, but Cambodia, you don't hear it often. Only few times you will hear that.
I didn't even know it was in Asia.
Yes. It's very, very rare.
I learned about many new animals.
New what?
Animals.
Oh, animals, okay. Arhan, yes, you have raised your hand.
Yes, no, I was saying that everything was new for me except its flag.
Oh, you knew about the flag?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that temple which you saw in that flag, the symbol they had, it's like that is where the Buddhism... they started to spread the awareness about the Buddhism. That's why 98% of the people follow Buddhism right now. That's why many Buddhist people come over there to pray. And even it's a very famous tourist attraction right now. If you go to Cambodia as if for a tourism, yes. you often visit Angkor Wat. That's how it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So, and I have one more video to show actually. So... I'll ask Manbi to share a video, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So did you know, interesting facts of Cambodian flag is the only flag which has a building as its symbol. Have you ever seen other flag with a building as its symbol? No, right? Like no. India has Ashoka Chakra and some other, Canada has that leaf, maple leaf, but no other country has a building as their symbol.
That is because everyone is different.
Yes, that is because everyone is different. And also because they give so much significance to that temple. So they wanted it to be their national symbol. And if you really like about all the animals, especially Abir, you like it, right? So Cambodia has many rare animals, actually. So if you want, you can go check it out. There are many, many rare animals in Cambodia, actually. So... And also they are very, in their cuisine, they are very fan of eating many insects. They have a wide cuisine with the insects in it. I didn't want to add it in the PPT because I didn't want to show it to you with that insects. So if you are interested, you can go check it. Okay. Okay. So, Indrani?
Yes. Ma'am, Cambodia is a relatively safe country for women for traveling alone.
Yes, that's great. That's so that when you are grown up, you can go have a trip over there. Okay, so Arika, you have raised your hand.
Yes, ma'am. I want to show you that bag which are made of Canada.
Okay, show it to us.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, very good. So that's the maple leaf that we see. That's beautiful.
Thank you.
That's really beautiful.
Thank you, Arika.
Okay, Indrani, you can take over.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, Swarna. So as you know that tomorrow we are going to visit?
Where?
Canada.
I hope you all are excited.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that's all for today's tour. Hope you enjoyed.
Yes, ma'am.
Bye.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am. Have a good day, ma'am.
Bye. Bye, ma'am.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.